Hi everyone! Welcome to Practicle Math. In today's video, we are going to learn some Primary 6 algebra basics. That's right, we'll lay the solid bricks step by step, and after learning all these basics, not only will you be able to understand algebra better, but you'll also discover the magical relationship between model drawing and algebra. Are you ready? Algebra? Before we begin, let's figure out what algebra is. I need all of you to think of algebra as a puzzle that involves an unknown. Okay, so here's one that all of you should be able to solve. 3 plus question mark equals to 7. Instead of putting a question mark in a box, in algebra, we use a letter to represent the unknown. And this letter can be any letter from A to Z. If you are curious about the most popular letters, they are definitely X and Y. So what have we learned? We now know that when we replace the question mark with the letter X, we transform the equation into a basic algebraic equation. And what makes that an algebraic equation? An algebraic equation is simply an equation that contains a letter. Okay, so this works too if we were to replace X with Y, or if we were to replace this Y by another letter, let's say K. Okay, now that we have an algebraic equation, the next step will be to solve it, just like all math equations. So since the numbers here are pretty small, it's easy to tell that 3 plus K equals to 7, this K must be 4, correct? So if we were to draw a model for this, it will look something like this. 3 plus k, everything will add up to give you a total of 7. Alright? Now that we have a simple idea of what algebra is and what an algebraic equation is, let's move on to learn some algebra rules. Rule number 1. The same letter must always stand for the same value in the same question. Okay, so what this really means is that whenever we have a letter, for example X, X must always stand for the same number. Okay, so for example, let's say today we have this equation, X plus X equals to 20. Although some of you might be thinking there is a few combination of numbers that will add up to 20, correct? For example, 119, 218, and so on and so forth. Okay, the only possible value of X here is actually 10. Okay, and this is because X must represent the same number. So if X is 10 and this is 10, 10 plus 10 gives us 20. Alright, now some of you might be wondering, but what if we don't want the value to be the same? Okay, well, we could do that. Okay, but we have to use another letter to represent another value. So if we wanted one value to be 1 and another value to be 19, we could change the equation to X plus Y equals 20. Although we could say that Y may have the same value as X, but because the letter is different, it's now possible for Y to actually represent a different number from X. Okay, so far so good? Now let's move on to the next rule. Rule number 2. The default operation for algebra is always multiplication. Okay, so like our usual numbers, algebra also have 4 basic operations. Okay, we have addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Okay, however, in algebra, multiplication is always the special default operation. Okay, so this means that if there are no signs in between a number and a letter, we can assume that they're being multiplied. Okay, so for example, here we have 2x. Okay, 2x is the same as saying 2 multiplied by x. Alright? So you see, instead of writing 2 times x over here, okay, we simply write the expression as 2x, and it's kind of like a shortcut to us. Okay, so similarly, when we see 10y, we read it as 10 multiplied by y. Alright? Now, on to the last and final rule. Okay? Rule number 3. When a single letter is seen, there is an implicit one in front of it. Okay? So the meaning of implicit is something like it's not said, okay, but it's understood. So since any number multiplied by 1 will result in the number itself, we will usually leave out the 1 when we are writing it. Okay? So therefore, when we see a single letter without any number in front, for example, x over here, we can interpret it as 1 multiplied by x. Alright, looks like we have come to the end of the lesson on Primary 6 Algebra Basics. We hope that you have a better understanding of what algebra is and some of its rules now. Now, after learning the basics, we want to know how much you think you have leveled up. Do you think learning algebra is going to be easy or difficult for you? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching Practicle Math. If you like this video, please make sure to subscribe to our Practicle channel right now. And if you want to get exclusive Primary 6 Math cheat sheets, head over to practicle.sg and sign up for a basic account today. It's free, okay? See you later, alligator!